and I am cutting and processing hardwood. This stand is predominantly almost 100% hardwood, and mostly hardwood pulp. There's a few hardwood logs, but I'm showing you guys basically how I do it, and the kind of the process of laying the wood down and then processing it. I don't always make big bunches like this, but just in this particular area, this is what I was doing. So, but I just was trying some different angles with my GoPro, and I had a suction cup I put outside the cab and tried a few different angles. And at the end of the video, I put the GoPro inside the cab so that you could watch me operate the machine, and I was at the same time talking about processing hardwood and how I do it, and kind of explaining some of the things that I do and stuff of that nature. So like, subscribe, share. I'm gonna keep pumping some of these videos out, and hopefully you enjoy it. So we'll talk to you later. watch the top of the trees as I was cutting them there. And you kind of see how I work up the hardwood. And this isn't really terrible hardwood, but it's not, it's kind of rough. So this Fabtech Far Roller is actually a pretty tough little head to deal with that hardwood. I really like the head other than the hoses that go into the side. You can see the wrap, the yellow wrap on this side. I've just fixed the other side, but I haven't gotten around to doing this side yet. And that's just from if you twist the head too far, it'll break that wrap. So, anyways, kind of see, you saw, you know, I was cutting some shorter wood that was 8'6" hardwood logs, pallet logs. We're cutting mostly pallet logs here. This is, you know, low grade wood. So, but now you can kind of see, you can't see the buttons right now, but you can see the joysticks work. Kind of see what it's like, what I do in here. A lot of people would say that this is easy, and it is for the most part. You're sitting inside a machine, it's air conditioning and heat. I have satellite radio in here, but I've got a lot of hours perfecting my operating ability. And you'd be surprised after you sit in one of these things for 8, 10, 12 hours a day how tired you are. I used to cut wood by hand, chainsaw and a cable skidder, when I first started. And, you know, yeah, I was more physically tired at the end of the day, but I never remember being having the stress level or being mentally tired like you tend to get with this stuff. With mechanical stuff, the overhead, a little more at stake with making sure everything's going and you're making enough money and production. But this job's a little difficult, just the trucking and stuff, but we're quite a ways from the mill, so I think it's 100 miles. Well, not quite, but and the road isn't all that great, so just having some obstacles, nothing we can get over. It's just adjusting and making a plan. So we're supposed to get a big snowstorm today, anyways. And there's a lot more to that processing this hardwood. I kind of went off in a different direction there, but you can kind of, if you pay attention to how I open and close the knives as I'm processing, that's, I mean, it's not just grabbing a tree and, you know, touching the trigger and feeding it through the head and delivering it. There's a lot more to it than that, and the way that you open and close your knives, I've done it so much, is you can look, you're looking at all the branches and the individual knots and stuff, and you can kind of tell how you open and close your knives, how it's gonna delimb. And because some of those knots, if you hold the knives right against the tree, it's too hard and the knots are too straight, it won't cut them off, so you're just gonna be beating back and forth. So a lot of times you open up the knives a little bit and it's hard to describe, but it kind of pops those limbs right off. Other limbs come out of the tree more at an upward angle and slices them right off. It kind of goes with the grain and pops them off. So a lot of running a processor is really opening and closing your knives, and that also has to do with the shape of the tree. Sweeps. If the tree's got big sweeps, you'll see me open opening up the knives. I'm running the tilt of the head, the side to side, and the up and down at the same time to kind of, you know, you picture like downhill skiing, and it's trying to follow the curvature of the tree. Otherwise, you're just going to ram the head into those parts of the tree, and it won't live. And so it's kind of funny because I've done this so long. It's such second nature. And it's so easy now that I don't really think about it. So, you know, that's kind of the basics. You didn't see a lot there, but in a lot of this wood here, there's a lot of nasty beech here and a lot of messed up tops. So you'll also see me taking the head and, you know, there's just crotches and branches that I know I can't get, or if I can, I'm just going to be, you know, ramming back and forth, which is hard on the head. And if you do that long enough for these heads, you're going to see structural failure at some point. I'll take the head and the saw and cut those crotches off. And, if the branches will allow it, I'll process more pulp out of it. Because this is a 3/4 pitch chain and bar. And they're very resilient. I've never run a processor with 404 pitch or what any of the other ones there, but those chains break easy and the bars bend easy. These bars are tough and the chains are tough too, unless you're really yanking on that chain or moving and sawing. You don't break a whole lot here. It's pretty rocky here, so I've rocked more chain here, hit rocks than anything else. And kind of, if you just nick a rock, you can sharpen it back and it'll be good. But a lot of times you rock a, you know, rock hard enough and then I just throw the chain out. You never get it cutting good enough again. And people try to be cheap, save those chains and use them, but they just don't cut good. It's wearing on the bar. I can tell. I mean, it's, you know, I can tell instantly when, like, in this machine, when the chain isn't cutting quite that good. And, you know, when you're making this many cuts a day, I don't mess with it. As soon as it feels like it's not cutting good at all, I take it off and put another chain on. It's just worth it to me. Maybe other people, you know, want to try and run it more, but you're wearing out your sprocket pins and wearing out your bars, and it's harder on the saw motors and the saw seals. So I don't mess with it. It's not worth it. I mean, I guess there is a point. I mean, the chains on these, they're 55 drive and 11 BC 3/4 pitch chain, they're about $50 a piece. So it's not like you just buy two or three chains every day, that get kind of expensive. But anyways, I just thought I'd try and explain a little bit about the processing. Doing some different angles with the GoPro. See how that comes out. If you have any questions or comments, that'd be cool. Subscribe, like, and share. We'll talk to you later.